Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about 7 mindset habits which helped me in my life. Mindset habits can help to determine how well your life goes or how peaceful your state of mind will be or how happy one with their life. I started to implement these mindset habits since last year and I want to implement more of this year as well. These mindset habits can be helpful for you too, or it might get that spark to help you to implement some mindset habits of your own you'd like to try. Let's get started. Being aware of thoughts, emotion, and action can be very beneficial to oneself and peace of mind. Being aware of your thoughts allow us to reframe our negative thinking to a more positive and realistic approach, and to come to an understanding to it, and to know the why behind the feeling. And it also helps us to move on in our life. It allows us to learn from our mistakes and grow as an individual. Our thoughts tend to be negative, but learning to reframe it is really powerful. This goes with argument, disagreement, and dealing with difficult emotion. It is very important to look at the different perspective and not just one. Albert Einstein said, "No problems can be solved at the same level of consciousness that created it." Awareness and seeing the perspective is very important for our well-being. It cultivates mindful living and it cultivates peace. My second mindset habit is live proactive, not reactive. A proactive nature is an attitude, not a characteristic. Essentially, a key difference between these two approaches is initiative. A person with proactive nature uses their initiative to assess the situation and taking action before proceedings happen, therefore maintaining a control. A reactive nature person may use their initiative but at a much later stage, or we can say a time when it is really hard to control. Relishing under stress, a proactive person excels in any hard situation. Analyzing the vision ahead, they can identify and think strategically as to how to overcome the potential and inevitable situation. Their forward-thinking nature would anticipate the waves and the choppy water ahead. Living proactive will help you to fight with the challenging situation and overcome the hardship. The next mindset habit here I want to talk about is take control of your life. You may not have many choices, and also life brings us many challenges on our way. But what you have is how you take the situation in your life. What I mean by this is that we have the power to deal with the difficult emotion and to cope with adversity. We have the power to control our thoughts. We cannot control what comes to our mind, but surely we can control where it leads to. We have the responsibility over the action we take. We have the power to overcome any struggle in our life. Knowing you have the control of some aspects of your life is a powerful mindset you could have. So taking control of your life can change all aspects, and this mindset will lead to control many emotion, thoughts, and the situation which you can face ahead. Next point I want to talk here is embrace the imperfection. So many of us strive for perfection in our lives, and honestly, if I would tell you, I was one of them. We run behind the perfect job, perfect family, perfect life, and you name it. In aiming for perfection, we think that we will be more happier or liked by others. However, in the pursuit of perfection, we always add a level of anxiety. When we embrace imperfection, we give ourselves time and freedom and also the permission to chase our dream without having the pressure of having the result tied to our self-worth. Accepting that you have not reached all your goal you have set for yourself, rather where you are now and how much you have grown. Being able to recognize and celebrate that small win you achieve on your way. My next point I want to discuss here is focusing on the progress than result. As the old saying goes, the road to hell is paved with good intention. It reflects the fact that many people set their goal which they cannot achieve. We have the best of intention, but somehow these intentions don't translate to execution and outcomes. This idea of focusing on process than the result has recently been seen in an interview with
productivity expert James Clear. Clear suggests that the best path of success is to focus on the process, system, and habits. The greatest benefits the goal provides is the direction. And once you have the clear direction, then your pretty much focus should be on the system and the process. Progress is what critically important to achieve your goal and make you success. If a goal remains far off and hard to measure, it's easy to lose motivation and drive. Let me give you an example. If you want to lose weight and you are setting your goal to lose 10 kg in a month, it's next to impossible. Rather, what you can do is you can choose to eat healthy for next 7 days. Walk for 20 minutes or do some exercise at your home. In this way, you can enjoy your daily progress as well. This is where the end result has been seen, but also at the same time, your progress will lead to the result. Next mindset habit I want to talk here is learn from failures. Richard Branson says, you don't learn to walk by following rules. You learn by doing and falling over. We make mistakes every day. While they are not life-changing and earth-shattering ones, they always exhibit one example as to what not to do next time. That's the learning what we need to accept. Even if you take time to thoroughly analyze your option and you think you are making the right choice, you don't always end up with the result you wanted. However, there is always an opportunity to learn from your mistake. It is important to recognize that mistakes are inevitable and living by trial and error is a natural process and part of our life. Growth will start as soon as you learn from your mistakes and try to accept your mistake and recognize it and make the appropriate effort to uncover what went wrong. Next mindset habit I want to talk here is enjoy the little things and live lighter. Since last year, after the pandemic, we have come to a situation where we tend to realize little things in our life. What I try to say here is, instead of focusing on the things we don't have, we should put our energy or focus into what we have. Showing gratitude increases happiness and well-being. The things what you have can make you happier than you think. And I would rather say it is all about where you are putting your energy into. If you see the bad in it, the life will suck. If you see the good in it, the life is good. I know it's a simple concept but hard to implement. But if you realize at the same time, whatever we have is more than enough to make us happier, that mindset is a powerful thing to have in your life. So these are the 7 mindset habits I have implemented and I want to implement in my coming time. I hope this will be helpful for you all too. If you like my today's video, please give a thumbs up and hit the bell icon so that you will get the notification of my video. Please subscribe to my channel and also don't forget to share this to whoever needs it. And stay home, stay happy, take care of yourself and your family. I will see you all in my next video. Until then, bye-bye.